are some local corporate headlines. The new operator of the Manila International Airport ready to take over on September 14. San Miguel Corporation President Ramon Ang says the new NAIA Infrastructure Corporation has secured funding for the project, which has a capex of 123.5 billion pesos, as well as an upfront payment of 30 billion and annuities of 2 billion pesos a year. NNIC's General Manager Angelito Alvarez also bared plans to reshuffle terminal assignments to decongest NAIA. The move getting the nod of the Transport Department.
It will be a gradual process. That's the best that we can do at this point in time. As I stated earlier, things will only normalize as soon as this two extension is completed.
Meanwhile, Globe taps FirstGen Corporation to power more of its facilities with renewable energy. The firm's deal will see ABS-CBN's sister firm to supply clean energy to 70 Globe sites in the next 2 years. And finally, British firm Actis betting big on the Philippines' largest solar power project. The company will be investing $600 million for Terra Solar of Meralco Powergen and Solar Philippines New Energy Corporation. Actis will get a 40% stake in the project, which promises to create 3,500 megawatts of solar power and 4,000 megawatt hours of battery storage.
President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. highlights the importance of trade management in sustaining the economic growth of Southeast Asia. He spoke at the Strategic Trade Management Summit in Taguig City Monday. Marcos maintains it's essential to boost initiatives for supply chain security and regional trade. He notes the Philippines has already launched a strategic investment plan for developing key industries. However, Marcos acknowledges trade management is a collective effort of all members in the global market.
But the work does not end there. We will continue to upgrade industry standards, modernize regulations, and further establish linkages through various trade and investment frameworks such as the ASEAN, Asia-Pacific Economic Cooperation, Regional Cooperation Economic Partnership, the Indo-Pacific Economic Framework for Prosperity. All these so that we can see a more competitive region in the future.
With all 23 senators voting in favor, the Create More Bill hurdles the Philippine Senate. The proposed measure aims to bring in more foreign direct investments to the country by enhancing tax incentives. This includes applying VAT zero rating and exemption to local goods and services. It also provides for a 100% additional deduction on power expenses of businesses and corporations and a 50% additional deduction for reinvestment in the tourism industry. The lower house approved its own version of the bill last March, with House Appropriations Committee Chairman Joey Salceda saying just last month they won't adopt the Senate's version. Salceda said the chambers will try to resolve the differences in the versions at a bicameral conference committee meeting.
Check on European markets first. They are up in afternoon trade with the German DAX higher by 0.7%. Investors are looking ahead to the European Central Bank's policy decision. That's on Thursday. The ECB seen cutting rates for a second time this year. As for Wall Street, futures are also pointing to a positive open after heavy losses last week. In focus this week, the first presidential debate between Vice President Kamala Harris and Republican bet Donald Trump. That's on Tuesday, as well as U.S. consumer prices data on Wednesday.